perpetual novena of the miraculous medal. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Come, O Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created. Let us pray. O God, you did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit. Grant us in the same Spirit to be truly wise and ever to rejoice in his consolation through Jesus Christ our Lord. O Mary, conceived without sin. O Mary, conceived without sin. O Mary, conceived without sin. O Lord Jesus Christ, who has vouchsafed to glorify by numberless miracles the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who devoutly employ her protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven, who with the Father and Holy Spirit live and reign, God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, who for the accomplishment of your greatest works have chosen the weak things of the world, that no flesh may glory in your sight, and who for a better and more widely diffused belief in the Immaculate Conception of your Mother have wished that the miraculous medal be manifested to St. Catherine Labouré, grant, we beseech you, that filled with like humility, we may glorify this mystery by word and work. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, O most compassionate Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your assistance, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, we fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To you we come, before you we kneel, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the world incarnate, despise not our petition, but in your clemency, hear and answer them. Amen. The Novena Prayer. O Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus and our Mother, penetrated with the most lively confidence in your all-powerful and never-failing intercession, manifested so often through the miraculous medal, we, your loving and trustful children, implore you to obtain for us the graces and favors we ask during this novena, if they be beneficial to our immortal souls and the souls for whom we pray. You know, O Mary, how often our souls have been the sanctuaries of your Son, who hates iniquity. Obtain for us then a deep hatred of sin and that purity of heart which will attach us to God alone, so that our every thought, word, and deed may tend to his greater glory. Obtain for us also a spirit of prayer and self-denial, that we may recover by penance what we have lost by sin, and at length attain to that blessed abode where you are the Queen of angels and of men. Amen. An act of consecration to Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. O Virgin, Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of your affection for us, and a constant reminder of our duties toward you. Ever while wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserved in the grace of your Son. O most powerful Virgin, Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin. O Mary, conceived without sin. O Mary, conceived without sin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. My dear family, we gather once again to worship our God. And to prepare for this Mass, let us ask the Lord to forgive us.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You're seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, source and origin of all fatherhood, who kept the martyrs Saint Andrew Dongla and his companions faithful to the cross of your Son, even to the shedding of their blood, grant through their intercession that, spreading your love among our brothers and sisters, we may be your children both in name and in truth, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, looked, and there was a white cloud. And sitting on the cloud was one who looked like a son of man, with a gold crown on his head and a sharp sickle in his hand. Another angel came out of the temple, crying out in a loud voice to the one sitting on the cloud, "Use your sickle and reap the harvest, for the time to reap has come, because the earth's harvest is fully ripe." So the one who was sitting on the cloud swung his sickle over the earth, and the earth was harvested. Then another angel came out of the temple in heaven, who also had a sharp sickle. Then another angel came from the altar, who was in charge of the fire, and cried out in a loud voice to the one who had the sharp sickle, "Use your sharp sickle and cut the clusters from the earth's vines, for its grapes are ripe." So the angel swung his sickle over the earth and cut the earth's vintage. He threw it into the great winepress of God's fury. The word of the Lord. The Lord comes to judge the earth.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Say among the nations, "The Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the people with equity."
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Before the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice and the peoples with his constancy.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Crown of life.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While some people were speaking about how the temple was adorned with costly stones and votive offerings, Jesus said, "All that you see here, the days will come when there will not be left stone upon stone and will not be thrown down." Then they asked him, "Teacher, when will this happen? And what sign will be there be when all these things are about to happen?" He answered, "See that you not be deceived. For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am he,' and 'the time has come.' Do not follow them. When you hear all of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified. For such things must happen first, but it will not immediately be the end." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes, famines, and plagues from place to place, and awesome sights and mighty things will come from the sky." The Gospel of the Lord.
All of us, by nature, are very curious. We desire to know more about our lives, about the future. God reveals certain things that he wants to know to us, and some things he keeps secret for his purpose. If you read the book of Acts, chapter 1, Jesus told his disciples not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father. And the disciples were curious no more. And they asked him, "Are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? When is it going to be? What hour?" And Jesus said to them, "You do not need to know the day or the hour that the Father has set by his authority. What you need to know is that the Spirit, the power, will descend upon you. What you need to know is that you need to wait in prayer. Just wait for him." And today in the gospel, Jesus had finished teaching in the temple. And one would expect that those who heard him would be reflecting on his powerful, challenging words. And that was not the case. They were talking about the splendor of the kingdom. Now, I've met people who told me that they attended Mass in this, our cathedral. They didn't talk about the beauty of the liturgy here. And they talked about how beautiful, how magnificent our cathedral is. So they were talking about how beautiful the temple was. And Jesus said to them, "Time is coming when the temple will be destroyed, And that would have been a surprise to them, a shock. So they wanted to know when. Tell us, when is this going to be? And that is the answer that Jesus gave them today. He says, see that you are not deceived. Because many will come to you and they will say, I know the time, I know the day, I know the secrets of God, I can reveal it to you. See that you are not deceived. How many of us have been deceived by people who claim to know tomorrow, to know our future, to know our destiny? And some of us consult them, we search the internet, and we go to them consulting them. And some don't even go to those who claim to be Christians and prophets. We also consult those who are not Christians, as Santerias, Saint Gromas, diviners, mediums, palm readers, those who can divine the future through cards. We consult them. Tell us about my life. Tell us, are we at the end times? Tell us, who is going to win the election? Tell us, is my child going to be successful? Tell us, when am I going to die? Out of curiosity, endless curiosity, we want to know our future. God reveals certain things to us, but some things he doesn't, because he wants us to follow him in faith. Faith is not knowing the future. Faith is knowing the God who is in control of the future. And he has called us to keep our eyes on him and stop worrying about tomorrow and start worshiping him who is in charge of our tomorrow. And it says in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11, I know the plans that I have for you, and they are plans for good and not for evil. Plans to give you a future full of hope. He doesn't reveal the plans for us. And what we need to know is that they are plans for our salvation, our good. So whatever that happens tomorrow, we are in peace in the hands of our Creator. So always keep in mind that our future is full of blessing if we can live the present moment in his presence. Grateful for the abundant blessings God pours out on us each day, let us join together in offering him our prayers.
For all members of the church, may the Holy Spirit strengthen us in our efforts to be living signs of God's mercy in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, especially in those nations beset by conflict, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those burdened by hardships, may they experience freedom through God's healing grace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, may God grant us a missionary zeal in our life of discipleship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all government leaders, will work effectively to end all racism and division in society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, may God gather them into the kingdom of heaven this day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of Maureen and Bud Waller. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and everlasting Father, hear our prayers and grant what we need to be faithful missionaries of your word. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruits of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruits of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for our praise and glory of his name, our good and good Lord.
Receive, O Holy Father, the offerings we bring as we venerate the passion of the holy martyrs, so that amid the trials of this life, we may always be found faithful and may offer ourselves to you as an acceptable sacrifice. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyrs, Andrew and his companions, poured out like Christ's to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Felipe, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us.
My dear family, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only for the word of my
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Let us pray. Renewed by the one bread as we commemorate the holy martyrs, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that abiding as one in your love, we may merit by endurance an eternal prize through Christ our Lord. Thank you for joining us this morning. And I don't know what I will see you before Thanksgiving, but I'm wishing you happy Thanksgiving. I appreciate the presence of our seminarian, Filippo. Thank you for joining us today. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.